Affirmed versus Alydar. It was perhaps the most memorable and dramatic rivalry in racing history. One that started early in their two-year-old year and carried through the 1978 Triple Crown, forever linking their names. Heading into the Travers, Affirmed had won 7 of their 9 meetings. But John Veach thought his colt Alydar was ready to win the big one.
I thought we had an excellent shot of beating Affirmed in the Travers. Alydar's race in the Whitney was brilliant. Running against J.O. Tobin, who was a crack four-year-old, he really demolished him. He came out of the Belmont stronger than he went into the Belmont, I thought. His race at Arlington Park against very weak competition was also a very brilliant effort. So we were very, very pleased, and after watching Affirmed run in the Jim Dandy and seeing him kind of struggle against some horses that he'd beaten convincingly early in the year, I was very encouraged. And Alydar came up to the race in just in great order, trained well, seemed to thrive on the environment of Saratoga.
A record crowd of 50,359 turned out in perfect weather to see the race, made even more dramatic when Affirmed's regular jockey, Steve Cawthon, hurt his knee and was replaced by Lafitte Pinkai Jr. Here's Chick Anderson's call.
And they're off. For the lead. Shake, shake, shake on the inside. Nasty and bold now. Affirmed is on the outside with Alydar. And they pass the stands. Nasty and bold along the inside. Affirmed on the outside. Those two are heads apart. Alydar is a very close third on the outside. Then back along the rail. Nasty and bold. They move into the turn. The first quarter in a leisurely 24-1. And the leader along the inside, shake, shake, shake by just a neck. On the outside, Affirmed is second, going under good restraint. Then two lengths back, now a length and a half, Alydar in third. And Nasty and Bold remains a very close fourth as they make their way down the back stretch. Affirmed on the outside, puts a head in front. Shake, shake, shake. Alydar is along the rail, and he's moving up along the rail. And a half went at about the same. 48 seconds. The pace is still slow. Down the backstretch, Alydar will force the issue with Affirmed on the outside. It's Affirmed holding the lead by a head. On the inside, Alydar has the rail and will challenge him from that position. Then it's a gap of two. Alydar suddenly has dropped back. Very suddenly, and appears to be out of the race. Here's Nasty and Bold getting through. Alydar is back in stride once again. It is coming on again. On the turn, Affirmed, and Alydar will make a run at him on the outside in second. Nasty and Bold in third, and the trailer is shake, shake, shake. Three quarters in 1:11 and three, and they're in the stretch. In the stretch, Affirmed and Alydar on the outside. Affirmed on the inside, Nasty and Bold third down along the rail, but Affirmed continues to maintain control of the pace. It's Affirmed, and he has it by a length and a half. Alydar driving, can't catch him on the outside. Nasty and Bold is there.
Everyone knew something had happened on the far turn, and the inquiry sign was posted with Affirmed's number blinking. The tower camera on the turn shows what transpired. With Affirmed racing in front, Pinkai moved abruptly to the inside, dropping over on Alydar. This caused George Velasquez to check sharply and severely take up his mount. Alydar dropped back several lengths, and some of the onlookers, including Veach, thought he might have been injured.
I was very concerned watching it happen because I was in a position where I really couldn't see the angle that I was looking at from, and I didn't know whether he looked as if he bobbled and then came up, and oft times when a horse does that, he's broken his leg.
Alydar was okay, but the original order of finish was not. Affirmed's number was taken down, replaced by Alydar. The victory was bittersweet. And it remains so for trainer John Veach.
It was a win, but not a win. It is, even to date, to think about disappointing. I was younger then, but certainly have not lost my enthusiasm. But Alydar meant so much to me. He was my first love. You know, it's like your first kiss. And my first Derby horse, my first world class horse, particularly as a colt. And I was so proud of him. And it was so exciting. The Triple Crown was exciting, but the Travers was going to be where Alydar justified himself. And to have it end that way, it was bitter then and bitter now.